I know what you've been through, been through the same. We used to be friends, boo. Don't let it go in flames. You got the letters I sent you. This has to change. You switched up your menu. I don't do games. Oh, I'm not trying to leave you. You know I got you.
I got you.
I got you.
I got you.
You also better believe too. I will quickly drop you. Yeah, I want you to see.
Baby, why you tripping?
Welcome to another episode of Ism-Isms with Constructive Criticism.
Yes, sir.
Damn. Yes, sir.
Introduce everybody coming from the left to the right.
Yes, sir. Yes. Man, it's your boy Barry A.D., man.
And I'm Seawater.
It's your boy, your OG player partner, Hill MC.
Go blood and break something online.
And welcome to another one, you know. Hope you enjoy. So, we're gonna talk about the Super Bowl performance.
Yeah, we jumping right into the Super Bowl, man. You know, Super Bowl 50 in San Francisco, California.
Man. It was a blessing. It was all year, too, my dog.
It was a beautiful big, thing, man.
It was about a million plus people out there, man.
Plus, they had a Chinese New Year's and a Japanese New Year's, I believe.
So it was lit out there, man. Unfortunately, man, me and my man Cold Blooded Great, man, we was out of town, man, in Arizona, man.
Mixing up that CPR project.
Rocking and rolling, man. You feel what I'm saying?
I'm mixing up that upcoming project of short, you understand, CPR, man. We're gonna revive this game, y'all. Connect and protect and respect, you know, got UE on there, got two short, UMC, Barry AD, Coach Bloody the Great, son of a line himself, and many more, man. We got Miami, Texas, Memphis, shout out to all y'all, New York, DC, I go on and on, man. This stuff gonna be live. So y'all get ready for that, but let's continue with the ism and the Super Bowl, man.
So we're talking about the Super Bowl, the whole aspect of it,
the halftime show.
Did Beyonce perform and stuff? Did she say something that was compatible to the Bay Area?
When we talk about new tours, we're talking about Beyonce first.
But like, yeah, man, you know, this is like a very interesting topic for me because, like, I do a blog called The Hugh Cipher that you can hit up on WordPress, and I was online, you know, I'm always online debating with people, doing research. I'm a web surfer, man, that's just what I do. That's a hobby of mine, and I seen a lot of people, man, was criticizing Beyonce, like, after she first did it. Like, a lot of radicals, a lot of feminists were coming on criticizing her, saying that she, over-sexualized the Panthers by them dressing in those uniforms and that it took away from the movement. But this was right after she did it. A little bit later, we started seeing the feedback from the so-called establishment.
They were trying to say that there was the wrong moment and the wrong time to do it. But
well, some
any
people
time,
were saying that.
But you know, people always gonna have stuff to say, man.
Right, because all the...
woman's performing, well, her performance should be accepted, whatever the performance is, right. And don't expect it.
Man, I'm looking at the intention.
Here's the thing, though. A lot of people didn't trip off the fact, though, that it's the 50th anniversary of the Black Panther Party. Mm-hmm. So she did that.
She thought it.
50th Super Bowl anniversary. 50th anniversary of the Black Panther Party.
That's what I said, the intention. Yeah. She had good intention.
Not everybody gonna be happy.
But if you don't understand the history, like you said,
exactly.
You don't know the history. That's the problem with life now. Right. With a lot of us.
Yeah.
If you don't know the history, then you speak on stuff you don't know about. You don't know why people do certain things they do. She had a reason behind it. A lot of people didn't know.
Just like there shouldn't be a Black History Month. You know, we're Americans, period. That's it.
Are you saying there shouldn't be a Black History Month because there isn't a White History Month?
Exactly. Exactly.
Al Sharpton has jumped on this boycott bandwagon. He says, don't watch because Hollywood, here's a quote, Hollywood has become like the Rocky Mountains. The higher you get, the whiter.
The whiter you get. Well, that's not necessarily true. And if it is, you know, that needs to change. What I find astounding is that we've had a president who is Black in office for the past 8 years, who gets most of his funding from the liberal elite in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
Yet there are not very many roles for people of color. How can that be? And why is it just now being addressed?
I can understand Jada Pinkett Smith's frustration that her husband wasn't nominated for, you know, he did a great job in the movie Concussion.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, what does that say about how people are selected for these awards?
Right. That's assuming they're selected by race, which I think would be a disservice to the people who are looking at the films and making the choices. Maybe they need to be more, you know, integrated and there need to be more diverse people in the process of electing.
In the Academy.
In the Academy.
The demographics of the Academy apparently are secret, but for the most part, according to some investigation out in Hollywood, it's predominantly white males.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah. So maybe that says something about who they select, or are they looking for that, or the best movies and the best actors?
I hope they're looking for the best movies and the best actors. The good news is that there's attention brought to it now. But like I said, over the past 8 years, we've had a president Black who gets his funding mainly from Hollywood, the elite liberals.
Yeah.
So it's odd to me that this has now become such an issue.
Well, let's see what happens, because they are calling for people not to watch it. Let's see if the ratings go down.
Yeah, I doubt it.
By the way, before you go, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
It's her birthday today. All
right, thank Stacey. You very much.
Thank you very much.
But they're going to hate, because
they don't want that.
But what she did was powerful. To back her up on that, Black lives do matter. Brother, can we get to Beyonce thing?
Yo. Well, let me elaborate on that, too. You youngsters, man, just real quick, you remember we used to go to Juvenile Hall and holler at them youngsters.
Right.
A lot of them is locked up because they don't even know their rights. I mean, they don't even know, like, the police not even supposed to talk to them without the parents, especially if they didn't do anything or any type of violence or crime at all. Right. So, say that is to say this, man. I got pulled over one night for no reason. No reason.
Mm-hmm.
Now my past history, weeks I'm trying to expunge my record.
Mm-hmm.
Pulled me out, and I had a few partners with me sleep in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Pull them out, and guess what he told me?
What?
The officer asked me to search my car.
Mm-hmm.
I refused. I said, nah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not on probation. Right. I'm there. It's like I'm not giving you guys no rights to search my stuff.
Right, right, yeah.
Guess what they say, y'all?
What?
Oh. My other partner from Compton, he's on probation. I said, well, that's okay. Search him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But you ain't searching my car.
Right. That's how they try to get you.
My father, check this out, y'all. Came to find out. I said, dog, why you tell me you're on probation? I'm not on no probation. So these are the tactics and lies they use to violate your rights.
Man, you gotta know your rights.
Man. He wanted me to say yes to something that wasn't even true.
Right.
The whole point is he gave me the right. The same thing the other day. Hold on. Same thing the other day.
Yeah.
We was driving.
Yeah.
I got pulled over.
Yeah.
They dragged us out the car.
For no probable cause.
Hold on, though.
No. No probable cause.
Did they ask any one of us to search the car?
No.
They searched me and searched the car.
Wow.
These are the things. And guess who I call?
Yo.
Amos Brown.
Yo.
Amos Brown, president of NWACP.
Yeah.
Pretty sure you guys all know him. I called him and he told me, do you have the badge number? That's the only mistake we made. Yeah. So y'all get this badge number And let's all stand together as one to fight this thing, right?
Let me add to that, man. You got to know your rights. Remember that.
They got
no probable cause. Hey, they can't search you. They can't do nothing. You know what I mean? Understand the law. You feel me? Talk. You know what I mean? Say that shit. Don't be afraid to tell them, hell no, you can't search my car.
Right.
No, you can't. I'm good. I'm not on probation.
It's inconvenience. Anybody being guilty about that?
You got to be innocent. You can't be crooked and then try to shoot.
Yeah.
Because your ass going down. You got to fight with the right.
Exactly.
You got to know. This can't be no bullshit when you start to step up. Right. That's why I big up to Beyonce. And we like to go on. And we'll finish it from Cam Newton to Cam Newton.
I just want to say real quick, man. I got to keep it real, man. Cam Newton disappointed me, man, with his demeanor after the game.
2 years ago had a tough time. They bounced back. Take that to heart when he told you after the game?
No.
Can you put a finger on what why Carolina did not play the way it normally plays?
Got outplayed.
Is there a reason why?
Got outplayed, bro.
Is there anything Denver did defensively that, I mean, I know you'd seen them, studied them, was it pretty much what you had seen on film? Was there anything different you think they put in for this game?
Nothing different.
Can you put into words the disappointment that you feel?
Did you see anything that you did?
They just played better than us. I don't know what you want me to say. It's like, they made better, more plays than us, and that's what it come down to. I mean, we had our opportunities. It wasn't nothing special that they did. We dropped balls. We turned the ball over. Gave up sacks. Threw errant passes. That's it. They score more points than that.
Can you put into words the disappointment you feel right now?
We lost.
I know you're disappointed not just for yourself and your teammates, because you guys talked about how you are a band of brothers coming in. It's got to be real tough for everybody in that locker room.
Load the box, force y'all to throw the ball. So you throw the football. That was game plan. Load the box,
I know he was upset.
Do you think it was rigged, man?
It was a big old.
Do you think it was rigged, man?
I don't think the game was rigged, man. He got sacked seven times.
Understood.
But this is my question, bro.
Yeah,
he was playing a veteran.
Let's debate and relate. Let's debate and relate.
Hey, we gonna put a segment up of Cam Newton. We let y'all be the judgment. And 3, 2, 1.
Man.
Like a
big old baby, man.
Look, watch this. He can play some football.
I'll tell you that.
Yeah, the
point. Understood. Look, he got hit. His line is not.
What is he doing, though?
But his line is not tight, though.
But he
can't scramble out there.
True that.
Yeah.
But let me ask this question.
The thing is, you supposed to die for that ball.
Oh, yeah.
You supposed to die for that ball, man. Super Bowl.
Hey, see, hold on, though. Like he dropped his phone.
Yes.
That's how it looked like to me.
Yeah. Well, that's the question I'm asking.
Man.
That is red. How, man, you only lost one game through the season.
So he said he got paid.
And
he got paid off.
He was untouchable. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm not saying nothing.
Right.
I'm just making men.
People make money. People make money.
Hold on, though. Hold on, though.
We ain't trying to go there.
No, we're not, but I'm saying.
I think he just froze.
I'm just saying is this, though.
Look at it.
Well, can I say my point, though?
You see his player diving, too.
Yeah. Can I say this, though?
Go ahead, go.
All I'm saying.
Blood?
Yeah. Is this.
What is it?
After you have came so far, you're supposed to get better.
Yeah.
After 13, so many games won, there's no way. I would be diving, flipping, and tripping after coming this far.
You know how to do it.
And the thing is this, I was doing this before.
Yeah.
Why, where, I'm, man, I'm at the line.
Froze up. Stays fried sometimes.
After so many games.
He never had a defense like that, though, man. Yeah. He was smacking him.
Well, Curry.